Someone say, it's in store, it's in store. 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 And exactly, God said to me, this is something that the unbelievers have worked for. It means, as a child of God, when you learn how to follow God, it will open your eyes. What the sister testified of, that's a small miracle. You find increase in your bank account. I release the word and it happens. That's a small miracle. There's something different now. This one is storehouse. Yeah. Melissa, are you there with me? This is a storehouse. Oh my God. If you know the weight of what God is saying tonight, you'll be shouting, you'll be crying out, because I know that the storehouse is not one thing, it's not two things, it's something for your future. Can I let you know, no devil can stop what God has for you in your storehouse. They can take one, they can take two, but there's so much in the storehouse. Only God's happening here. There's somebody here. The devil said to you, it's over, because they got ready. Your storehouse is about to be opened unto you. Say yes. I don't know what I came here for. I'm closing right now. You have been looking at little drops of miracle here. Blessing here. But I'm going for the storehouse. There's something about the storehouse. When you talk about storehouse, it's more than one thing in them. It's not just a drop here and a drop there. It means somebody, you are going for the biggest kingdom. I hear God say, the devil can't stop. It's too big. It's too big to handle. Lift your hand, say, it's too big to handle. It's too big. That's why, if they lie against you, God will lift you up. Oh, if they talk about you, God will lift you up. It's too big to handle. Shout, it's too big to handle. Forget about people who say they were competing with you. Nobody can compete with you when you have your storehouse. I'm not just going for a little miracle here. I'm going for the storehouse. I told God, Father, help me to follow you, because I will follow God to my storehouse. There's something that God is saying to me to remind somebody, you are just what you see now. It's a trickle of what God has for you in the storehouse. That's why the enemy is trying to mess you for following God. They know if you follow God, you are coming out with your hands lifted up. You are coming out with a victory song. They know if they allow you to follow God, you are about to overtake them. They know if they allow you to follow God, so that the distraction here, distraction here. Stop and say, follow God. I'm closing right now. Because God said, man, it says, but the sinner's word is stored up for the righteous. So why can't I prosper? And I said, God, there are many in the church too much, and they are struggling when there's a storehouse. Perhaps it's your level of worship. Perhaps it's your level of following God. And the Lord told me, he said, let them know it is stored up. Let me say it is stored up. But as you obediently follow him, it is released gradually into your account. So it is stored up. Name on it. There's a lot of breakthrough with your name on it. Many of you right now, you receive major contracts. God is about to bless you. You and my God, they look at you ordinary, but heaven says you are extraordinary. Lift your hand and give God praise here. I hear God say, your time of breakthrough is coming, but don't you ever give up, because there's a major transfer coming, not just for you, but to Guyana. A major transfer is coming. If you just learn how to follow him. Stop and say, there's a major transfer coming. I hear God says, I prophesy over the nation of Guyana. There's a major transfer coming. I want to know, you went through crisis for the past 1 year, but I hear God say, the coming year, there's a major transfer of welcoming in this nation. I'm hear God say, they try to stop this nation, but I'm sorry. I hear God say, my people, if you follow me, I will give you the word of the wicked. I receive it, brother. I receive it. Why can't I be happy in God? Why can't I prosper in God? The devil is a lion. Many people, they watch you now. They look at you with disdain. They watch you from head to toe. You are nobody. But you can tell yourself, after today, I know God. There's a storehouse for me. I ain't coming here to gossip. I'm coming here to follow you, God. I came here because I know it's a place of transformation. No weapon from against you shall prosper. I hear God say, your hour of breakthrough is coming. Stand your feet and give God praise here. I don't hear God. I know there's somebody here. The devil tried to mess you up. But God says, your time has come for a major shift. Say yes. Nobody can compete with you, baby. I don't care what they say. I know somehow we make some mistakes. We wander away from God. We step out of God's zone. But you can get back yourself because you're going to the storehouse. Don't, my God, it's time for someone to tell himself, I don't know where I am right now, but after today, I'm going to the storehouse. I don't know. The devil has tried to stop me. That's why sometimes I tell my enemies, why are you jealous when God bless me? Why are you crazy when God bless me? You got to hold. All you got to do is to follow. When you get to the storehouse, the treasures of heaven will be open unto you. Tonight, I ask somebody right now in this place, don't play church anymore. Don't play church anymore. Harley Quinn, I told God, I said, God, if there's so much in your kingdom, I refuse to lack. I'm not just hyping you, I'm telling you. I said, I refuse to lack. I said, God, show me how to follow you. I might make mistakes here, mistakes there. I bounce back. Get back your shoes. There are devil, you just miss one. I'm going to follow God. But Job said, even though he slay me, yet will I trust him. Can I let you know, church? It's time for us to stop playing church. I sense in my spirit that greatness is coming. Many of you don't know what I'm talking about. Mark the prophecy I just said just now. Greatness is coming. And when it hits, you must be there to follow. You must be in the right place at the right time to meet with the right person. Tonight, you might ask yourself the question, Pastor, is this still possible in this DNA, in this wicked and profane generation? Is this still possible to follow God? Pastor, I mean, I showed you the last time about Noah. Noah stood upright in the midst of everything that was going on. But there was a man called Noah. He was upright before God. And God bless him. While others were crying out, God bless him. Because he was willing to follow God without question.
tonight, I want to ask you a very simple question. I sense in my spirit there's a lot of delayed blessing. As I preach, I know what I'm saying. I sense in my spirit that many of us are operating below our capacity. There's so much in our lives. There's so much grace that God has given to us that we have not even tapped into yet. But we are busy just fighting each other for little things. We are busy just pulling each other down for some stupid things. We are busy pointing little finger here, little finger there. We are busy watching somebody back. Meanwhile, your own back is open right there. Man, and we are so interested into hearing bad news about somebody. God, how can I remain a follower of you in such a mediocrity? In such a time where people don't really understand love for one another. God, how can I survive this wicked generation? But the Bible says Noah followed God. And God bless him. Psalm 75 verse 7 again reminds us. Bible says he judges. He brings one down and he lifts up another. There's a consolation for you to follow him. Don't care how long it takes. God will judge them for you. I am not afraid of those who castigate me, who try to pull me down because of the blessings of God upon my life. I'm not afraid of those who try to intimidate others to stay away. But I know that he is the master judge. If you keep on following him, he will judge them for you. In the book of Psalms, we are reminded that times and seasons are in his hands. He can change them. That's why I'm here to encourage you. As you follow him, expect a change of season. Never anybody that followed God rightly, you can never remain in one season. Something is wrong. He changes times and seasons. Don't lie to me. You can never follow God uprightly and remain in one season. I've tested God. I've seen God. I know what it means by season to season. Daniel reminds us. He pulls one down and then lift up another. There's nothing God can do for you. Don't care who's up against you in your face. Don't care who don't want to respect you. When you follow God, God will make your enemies to bow down before you. Those who don't want to talk to you before, they will talk to you now. Just forget and just follow him. Tonight, my key word is follow him. Wherever you find yourself, keep on following him. You might be in the midst of your biggest trial, keep on following him. Nobody's there to support you, keep on following him. Even when your friends run away from you, keep on following him. Bible says he will judge them for you.